I'm sure bizarre things happen all the time, normally, do in our household anyway, but somehow they seem even more bizarre under the current circumstances. Or maybe there's more of them happening. Being locked in must heighten our awareness of the strange stuff that happens, and I suppose we subconsciously look for the humour in our situation as a way of relieving boredom or anxiety or our general existential angst. You even find yourself using the kind of pretentious phraseology that you haven't used since you were writing essays at university several decades ago. But during this lockdown, I've seen members of the church meeting in a virtual pub, which is, I suppose, ideal for those who don't like sharing the pork scratchings or queuing up behind a person who can't remember all the elements of the 16-item round he's just offered to get. I've gone out into the back garden to find my wife wandering around in the sunshine, expounding a passage from 2 Samuel 24 on the phone, but at a volume that had attracted a small crowd in the street. So I went out and took up an offering before they dispersed. Actually, that's not all wholly true, that bit, but look out for a sermon on the threshing floor of a rauna before too long. I've seen video clips of other family members doing their daily keep fit in front of the television in scenes reminiscent of 1980s daytime viewing, watching the Green Goddess or Mr. Motivator on Good Morning Britain. And my mum has been left staring blankly out of the window with no one to wave to. It's being confined to the house, isn't it, that makes it all seem so weird. At least we're not yet threatened with the fines if we leave the house, unnecessarily, that many of our overseas friends have been. God, however, is quite content to flout the guidelines. He takes no notice of the decrees to stay at home and confine himself to the celestial jasper throne or whatever. In Psalm 139, David, another person who was constantly bemoaning his lot in life, so you're not the only one, he remarks that wherever he goes, God's there. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me, your right hand will hold me fast. You see, although it's sometimes very difficult to believe it, God does know what's going on. And whatever our situation, however deep our despair, God is with us, each and every one of us. Through his Holy Spirit, he makes his presence known and can bring help and comfort. He will guide us and hold us fast, as David says. If it seems that he isn't there, maybe it's because of our tendency to focus on the problems rather than listen for his voice and feel his touch. Our great and glorious leader spoke in some of his early news conferences about putting an arm round those who are struggling. But I think I'd rather have God's arm round me than Boris's, whatever the situation. With Boris cloistered away in number 10 or cabinet briefing room A or intensive care even, God is an infinitely more accessible and far, far wiser support at this time. So enjoy the bizarre. Chuckle at the odd things that are happening in the midst of such a difficult situation. Laugh at the antics of others and some of the quite frankly awful jokes that are appearing on the Wade Street Church social page, and keep a good lookout for God coming alongside you when things are starting to get you down. Keep smiling, keep praying, keep safe, keep praising.